So to implement a shared element transition, we need to designate which views are shared. We do this by setting the same transition name attribute on the views in both activities. I tend to use a string resource to make sure they match exactly. Next, when we launch the activity, we need to use a variant of the activity options make scene transition animation API that lets us specify the shared elements. We pass this API the view and the transition name so that it can look for its counterpart in the launch activity. There are variants of this API for specifying a single shared element like this, or ways to specify many shared elements if you want multiple things to transition. Note that interestingly, the transition name field is a string, rather than perhaps identifying a view by ID. This is because shared element transitions don't just work between screens within your own app. You can publish the transition names you support and have shared element transitions between different applications. Pretty rad. So that's enough to create a shared element transition. Not too much effort for quite an impressive effect. You may be wondering how the system knew to animate the size and position in our example. Well, by default, shared element transitions use a built-in transition called move. This is what it looks like. The change bounds transition does a lot of the heavy lifting and moves and resizes elements between states. The remaining transitions help with images to change the transformation and clip applied to them. If you want to customize the animations used, then we can create our own transitions and set them in a similar way to the activity content transitions. Here's how you'd set a custom transition via XML and via code.